there are over 20,000 accepted orchid species, with more being found regularly. They have devised incredible ways of capturing their pollinators' attention, each with their own style.
Take a look at this species. It belongs to the Paphiopedilum genus, one of the four genera that make up the orchid subfamily called the slipper orchids. This group is so called because of their most defining characteristic, the slipper-like pouch. The name Paphiopedilum was coined by Ernst Hugo Heinrich Pfitzer in 1886. Paphiopedilum means literally Aphrodite's sandal, from the word Paphos, a place considered to be sacred to Aphrodite, and pedilum for sandal. In most orchids, one of the petals, the lip, normally represents a landing runway for the pollinator. It is differentiable by shape and usually color. Its most common shape is a tongue-like shape. However, here, the lip has been transformed into a pouch. But it still plays a very important role in the pollination process. In Paphiopedilum, the two other petals can be easily spotted because they look like wings, with wavy edges located to the left and right of the pouch. As for the sepals, unlike most orchids, Paphiopedilum has a dorsal sepal at the top of the flower that looks like the traditional, ceremonial mitre. The two other sepals are fused together behind the pouch. The reproductive parts of Paphiopedilum flowers start with a structure called the column, an extension of the ovary and stem. On both sides of the column, we can see the two active anthers, and at the end is an infertile anther, the staminode, which serves to protect the stigma behind it. The whole setup is a perfect trap to lure unknowing insects searching for nectar into pollinating the flower. The insects are attracted by the colors of the flowers that promise nectar. In searching for this nectar, the insects eventually fall into the pouch. Inside the pouch, the walls are slippery. And once it's inside, it's impossible to fly out because of a liquid base that drenches them. There is only one way out. They need to climb a ladder of hairs provided by the orchid that lead all the way up to behind the staminode, which then leads to two different exits with two different anthers. So whichever path they take, they will end up carrying the pollen. Thus, in the process of escaping, they either collect or deposit it. And that's how the smart flower fooled the innocent insect. Orchids have been in the evolutionary game for so long, most species have evolved to specialize in attracting certain pollinators. They have a wide variety of shapes, sizes, colors, and even smells. All this to adapt perfectly to their environment, ensuring their continued survival.